5-14, and looking to put the first touchdown on the board here.
Power eye formation. Thomas runs the option to the right. Turns it upfield at the 15, and he's down to the 12-yard line. A gain of 5. The junior quarterback out of Point Clear, Alabama. And that sets up 2nd and 5 from the Troy 12 with 4:48 to play.
Colonels run the no-huddle offense, come to the line rather quickly now.
Again, the stack guy, Kip Roner, wide to the right side. Thomas, hands on the counter to Coach, trying to come outside, cuts back inside and goes nowhere, and here is a flag down, two of them, just as the play comes to a close, and that could be on Nichols State, and it is a holding penalty.
I think they caught Toby LaFont holding on the play. Toby just trying to get his running back, or wing back, actually, Mark Coates, some running room, but good job defensively there by the Trojans. They were kind of waiting and laying for that counter play, and the coach really didn't have anywhere to run on it. And the holding penalty is going to be just another setback for the Colonel offense. As we mentioned all night, they've been able to drive the ball deep into Trojan territory, but for one reason or other have not been able to put more than 3 points on the board, and that's something I'm sure Coach Barbier can't be too pleased with. You're pleased with the offensive output as far as yardage is concerned, but you've got to be able to put 7 points on the board or more than that to beat a team like Troy State. Troy State has showed us how to do it. Three possessions. Out of the three possessions in the second half, they've got 2 touchdowns.
Power eye formation, 2nd down and 15. Thomas to throw, near side to Roner, and he's got it at the 13-yard line. A quick hitch to Kip Roner, and the Colonel's leading receiver has his 3rd catch of the night. A gain of about 9. It will set up 3rd down and still about 6 yards to go.
And boy, Shipman really wasn't very happy with that. Shipman glaring at Kip Roner after the reception as if to say, how dare you catch a pass in my area. Roner and Shipman have been going at it all night.
3rd down and 7. Thomas, play fake, looking backside. He's going to try to run it, and he's taken down in the backfield. Good tackle by Pratt Lyons, the defensive end.
I'm not really sure what that play was designed to do. Really only one guy going out in the pound, and that was Roner. Thomas saw a little crease up the middle, trying to make a run for it, was unable to do so. 4th down coming up. The Colonels will call a timeout to talk it over.
Timeout on the field with 3:26 left to play. Nichols State trails 17-3. This is Colonel Football on KTIB. Nichols State facing 4th down, 8 yards to go from the Troy State 15-yard line. 3:26 remaining in the ballgame. The Colonels trail 17-3. This is pretty much the ballgame right here, riding on this play. Nichols State, if they're to have any opportunity here, needs to convert on this play. 4th and 8 from the 15. I formation, 2 receivers out to the left. Play fake, Thomas back to throw. Has a screen set up to the far side. Terrence Spears, oh my goodness, is he in trouble. He fumbles it on the ground, and Troy State recovers it back at the 22-yard line.
Darren, that situation, that ball was not thrown very well by Corey Thomas. You've got to give the running back, the ball's got to be delivered to him in front of him and up the field, and the ball was kind of thrown behind Spears. Spears had to make a stutter step to make the catch. When he did so, he started to backpedal, and that was all she wrote in that possession.
The Nichols State Colonels led 14-10 with 6 minutes to go in the 3rd quarter before Northwestern State came to life in the 2nd half and won the ball game 34-14. It was a 10-7 Northwestern State lead at the half, but the Colonels took the lead midway through the 3rd quarter when Reggie Davis returned a fumble 62 yards for a touchdown to give Nichols State a 14-10 lead. Northwestern State added a field goal just before the end of the 4th quarter to make it 14-13 going into the final period. Nichols State had a 1-point lead, but the 4th quarter is when Northwestern State came to life and took over. Clarence Matthews scored twice, with 10:29 to play in the ball game to give the Demons the lead for good, 20-14, then tacked on some insurance at the 2:12 mark to make it 27-14. The Demons scored a Lagniappe touchdown with 18 seconds left to play in the ball game to widen the final margin to 34-14. Looking at some individual stats, Clarence Matthews, the stellar tailback for Northwestern State, 32 carries, 171 yards. Corey Thomas led the way for Nicholls State, 70 yards on 11 carries. Nicholls State was held to just 168 yards on the ground. That, the team, Nicholls State, of course, second in the conference in rushing at over 200 yards per game, and that was the difference. Also, you add four Nicholls State turnovers, two fumbles, and two interceptions, and there you have the difference in the ball game, and particularly in the fourth quarter. Nicholls State now 0-6 on the season. Things certainly don't get easier next week. They take on the fourth-ranked Lumberjacks of Stephen F. Austin in Nacogdoches. That's the story from Natchitoches, Louisiana, 34-14, the Demons over Nicholls State. Darin Fontz, KTIB Sports.